Please welcome the delightfully funny Steve Hofstetter, everybody. Steve Hofstetter.
And so may the jokes about getting old.
I'm not afraid to die young. I'm not. I'm afraid to die old.
This is H2O, the album that One on One is on.
So talk about what people can expect when they come out and see you perform.
I'm hilarious. So there's that.
That tends to help.
You guys are clearly a cocaine crowd. That's classy. I like that. Responded way more to cocaine than the other drugs. I know right away if I'm playing to a crystal meth crowd, because they'll be like, that joke is so funny, man. That joke is so good.
I like this studio. This is a very 70s porn vibe. What IKEA would be like in the 70s. Yeah.
And it's a pay what you want album.
This is cool.
Yeah, so anybody who is interested in it can go and pay what they want. If they want to pay a penny, they can pay a penny, because they were going to steal it off the internet anyway. I got my new book. I'm really
right
excited
here.
About.
Yes.
Yeah, it's
National Lampoon.
Yep. It's called Balls, which allows me to sign it with rather flippant things.
Yeah, great.
I get to say stuff like, my balls are on your coffee table.
Thanks for having me.
I guess, we'll shake. It was a little awkward there.
It's like the man hug. You don't quite know what to do, but you're like, all right, let's do it. It's not just about the laugh. The laugh is first and it's most important. But beyond that, you can also educate people. You have that option.
And listening to the CD, it's not an uncomfortable thing. Though when you do it, it's funny, and you kind of look at yourself and you laugh, which is...
Yeah, it wasn't near as uncomfortable as the handshake before.
Laughs for Leukemia is a comedy show helping those in need.
And the man putting it on right now is Steve Hofstetter.
I think I'm willing to place a wager on this game if you're interested.
What wager?
All right, here's a wager. If I'm playing the Boston Comedy Festival in September, in late September, all right? If the Yankees win, I will wear a Yankees hat in Boston on stage in late September.
Will you change the color of your head?
And my eyes, they're blue. I'm blue and orange. If the Mets win, though, you got to wear a shirt on the program next week that says proud to be number two.
Proud to be number two.
And you do, you know, pretty much a little bit of everything, it seems like.
I try to.
And you're huge on college campuses right now.
It's a whole week of stand-up smarts with the hottest names in comedy.
Yeah, John Rocker, the
Forgot
Ku Klux
about
Closer.
John. Ku Klux Closer.
We had, that guy played Third Reich.
Because I'm really curious, and obviously we're going to learn stuff from you, but I think this show is more about what you guys are learning from this trip. So what is it that has so far most surprised you about this country that you didn't know before?
Well, you're amazing, especially for such a young man.
Thank you.
27.
I'll be 28 in a year.
Taco Bell Express. Because Taco Bell was not fast enough. Taco Bell could be ordered, cooked, wrapped, sold, eaten, crapped out the back under 5 minutes. How do you make that more express? Take a burrito, throw it directly into the toilet. Like, that's it. And that will save you 35 seconds.
My favorite thing on MySpace is the mothers who put pictures of, like, their kids and then put pictures of them, like, half naked. It's such a weird, like, combination. Like, I don't understand. They'll be like, oh, this is my angel Jonathan, and here's me bent over my couch. Like, I don't understand the...
One day, I'm going to make it. I'm going to be in a shopping mall in Memphis, and here I am.
You have made it.
I don't want to end up preaching to the choir, and if you're too one way, then you end up pushing away people who are not with you, and only pulling people in who already agree with you. I want to reach the people on the fence. That's really what I want to do.
I read an article that said the Bible was the most bought and sold book in America last year. That's true, as it is every year, but you know what number two was last year? It's Harry Potter. Bible number one, Harry Potter number two. That means a book where a boy magician defeats the evil lord of the underworld sold better than Harry Potter. It takes a second, but it's gold. Hey, you guys have been awesome. Thank you so much. Thank you for listening. Have a good night.